Well, June had arrived, and Allie and I were heading north for a job. I had been working hard to get the old Volkswagen van ready for the trip, but alas, some of the electrical still wasn't working. And so we loaded up the old Rover and headed off in excitement to a state I don't visit as often as I would like to. And there were signs of summer the whole way north. One of the most magic parts of the trip, besides the dragonflies you'll see later on, was this hillside of flowers along the winding road. It went on for at least a mile through the bends and winds, and in some sections, the lupines were rainbows of different colors. It's the little unexpected moments on trips like this that I make an effort to cherish. We knew the cabin and the lake we were heading to would be beautiful, but we had no idea we'd see a billion flowers on a back road, or a beautiful stream with some great-looking trout runs. And come October, in the season of reflection, all the dried flowers on the dash from trips like these will serve as reminders of time well spent. And we arrived just after nightfall, the little yellow camp where we'd be working out of for the next couple days. And we woke up to the sound of the rain. We were feeling a bit nervous, as we were here to do summer photo and video work for a small brand, and we were hoping for some golden light conditions. The trip had been booked well in advance, so we were stuck with these conditions, however they would end up playing out. And while this was calming and beautiful in its own way, usually when you get hired for a summer lake life kind of vibe, you don't picture rain and fog. So I thought about what we would do if worse came to worse, as all the upcoming days had clouds on the forecast. The last thing you want to do in a scenario like this is panic and get upset. When you're dealt cards that you can't change, the best thing you can do with your energy is put it towards the next best route. And since we couldn't shoot much during the rain, we spent the day planning, being present, and exploring our surroundings. Thank you. And as we walked, we saw honeysuckle, rhodies, and daisies.
What is it?
But the most curious thing were thousands of new dragonflies tucked in the bushes, waiting for the sun, just like us. And we ended the day with some fresh local seafood and went to bed with our fingers crossed for sunshine. And while there was no rain this next morning, there were still clouds, but we were optimistic and planning to work with what we had today regardless.
The birds sound so pretty.
They do.
All right, I'm so excited to eat.
Hopefully it won't though, or it'll be really on and off so we can do pizza.
I mean, yeah, there's only a 30% chance when I saw you today.
Yeah, I think it's still low, just longer.
Mary, the owner of the small business we were working for, was meeting us today, and we were going to interview her as part of a video for her website. I worked with Mary last fall and showcased her bags in one of my videos, but this time around we were diving deeper into her story because it's inspiring and her creations truly are top quality. And so I picked some strings while we waited for her to arrive. And then it was time to tell her story.
There are 250,000 tons of textile waste in Massachusetts alone. 90% of it could be repurposed or upcycled. I'm Mary, and I'm the founder and creator of On the Road Again. On the Road Again takes durable materials sitting in warehouses, waiting to go to landfills, and we repurpose that into fashion-forward goods. So my mom passed away when I was 20 years old, and so she was a seamstress and she worked from home. She was a mompreneur before the term became popular. I've kept the house that I grew up in, and my workroom is in the same room as her workroom. So I feel like she's guiding me and she's there. So I've been coming up here to Maine, to the Lake Sebago region for over 20 years. And so the name of the Raymond Tote comes from the town here in Raymond, Maine. The beach bag was the initial premise of the bag, but you know, we've had school teachers use them because they're so durable and they can carry all their books. People that go to the gym because it's a breathable mesh. The mesh material that I currently use on the bags, we actually get that from a company that's based right here in New England in New Hampshire. It's used in the boating and trucking industry. You can hose it down. I mean, how many people can literally hose down a bag? We use seatbelt webbing for the handle, so that's very strong. We reinforce the seatbelt webbing with grommets, and they're all US-made grommets too. And we give back, so we partnered with One Tree Planted, so when you make a purchase, we plant a tree. We also use non-plastic materials when we ship our products out. The Liberty tote bags are very special. The red, white, and blue mesh originally was created for the dump trucks that were hauling out debris during 9/11. For every sale of that bag in the Liberty line, we donate back to the 9/11 Memorial Fund down in New York. We do placemats. They're easy to clean and you can keep them, you know, indoor, outdoor use, and then you just rinse them off and then hang them away to dry. On the road again is just me right now, and that's what it has been for the last 4.5 years. I started the business as my side business, and I do work full time. I am a sales professional. I work nights, I work weekends, days off I'm working, and I just want to continue to create great products for people. And I think that's one of the most rewarding things is when people say, I love this bag, it's so durable. It's just so rewarding to hear that people truly appreciate something that I created.
So we shot with Mary all afternoon, and as luck would have it, the clouds broke and the sun showed up after all. But the rain was still hanging around. In and out the weather went, and we took our golden opportunity to paddle out and explore some of the islands on the pond and get some more shots for Mary.
Wow.
We were feeling grateful that the weather had pulled through for us, and so we paddled back to the little yellow camp, excited for dinner.
Rusty red on her shoulder, I was cleaning her shoe. When it clicked on the trot over in the bright morning dew, we brushed paused and we braided dandelions and chewed. It was a mutual arrangement we both saw into. Can she walk in the fire? Can she run in the rain? Can she make it up the mountainside? Can she make it down again? I have often wondered if she'll go and jump the fence. Will she keep on moving onward or stay in what could have been?
And we had our favorite summer special. Homemade sourdough pizza.
Broke my arm in December. We were running for the thrill. You turned in the canyon to the snowbank where I fell. Even still, I remember knowing she could feel it too. Was a mutual arrangement. We both knew.
And on our final morning, the sun cut through the fog and made for a beautiful show.
We had a deep understanding, never had to use a bit. Wasn't Can she walk in the fire? Can she run in the rain? Can she make it up the mountainside? Can she make it down again? I have often wondered if she'll go and jump the fence. Will she keep on moving onward or stay in what could have been? Will she keep on moving onward or staying what could have been?
So what started as a somber and rainy trip ended in a triumphant sunshine morning, and we were able to execute the job we were hired for in the end. All we had to do was stay patient and diligent. And though the trip was full of beautiful tiny details and glimpses of summer, it was the thousands of dragonflies that I'll never forget. And while we worked hard and had fun, we were excited to get home and get back to work on my cabin. Old Blue and Georgie the van were moments away from being road ready, and soon the strawberries would be ripe and the fields full of fireflies, and we'd get lost in the dreamy golden haze of summer.